There are no exceptions. To allow the contrary view would be setting a deadly precedent. It would allow any official to hide his assets behind the cloak of the Foreign Currency Deposit Act. Does that make sense? It does not, both from a legal point of view and from a lay person's view. Bakit pwedeng itago ang pera sa dolyar? Makatarungan ba yun? Republic Act 6426 on the secrecy of foreign currency deposit is not an exception to the law requiring the declaration of the SALN. In fact, it is easy to reconcile the same. A government official should declare his assets and liabilities, but then no one can examine the bank account without his written consent. The defense then posits the view that misdeclaration in the SALN is minor and therefore not an impeachable offense compared to other impeachable offenses like bribery and treason. As a lawyer, to me, minor inaccuracies in the SALN, such as parking lots or a unit whose ownership is under contention, would not amount to betrayal of public trust. In fact, corrections are allowed under the law. But the failure to declare $2.4 million and some 80 million pesos is not minor. In decided cases, the Supreme Court has ordered the dismissal from service of public officials and employees for failure to declare a sari-sari store, two motor vehicles, and for non-declaration of several assets such as real property and bank deposits. These are the cases of Rabe versus Delsa Flores, Ombudsman versus Nieto, Racho Flores versus Montemayor. I also have difficulty accepting the defense of commingled funds. Yes, the fact of commingling of funds, I believe, is common among families. But the huge amounts involved leads much doubt in my mind. In our interpretation of the law, we who hold a position of public trust must choose the interpretation that will uphold public interest over private interest, regardless of whether malice or an intent to suppress the truth was present. We must remember that public office is a public trust. Once that trust is gone, we must step down to preserve the integrity of the position we hold. Pag nawala po ang tiwala ng taong bayan, dapat po bumaba na sa pwesto. Dapat po pangalagaan ang posisyon na yon. Lastly, we need to remember that we can only mature as a democracy if we can learn from this impeachment experience. From the start, I questioned breaches in procedural law and ethical conduct of various participants in the impeachment process. The trial by publicity, the irresponsible hurdling of bloated, unverified figures and assets, among others. My fervent hope is in the future, the pursuit of justice will be conducted in a more responsible manner, lest our children are left with the impression that those accused of wrongdoing can be persecuted without respecting their rights. The other lesson must go beyond the Chief Justice. It is the call for transparency. I echo that call. Those of us who sit as judges, those of us who act as prosecutors, and all those in public service should not hide behind our titles. We must come clean and give meaning to the constitutional requirement that we declare all our assets. Mr. President, on the accusation made in Article 2, I find the respondent guilty.
Honorable Senator Jeds Defensor Santiago.